There we go.
Okay.
Ham radio now, quickie. I think this will be a quickie. Is this going to be a quickie, or we could talk for an hour?
I'm fine.
At the Orlando HamCation, I am Gary Pierce, KN4AQ, with the HamCation. I'm trying real hard not to say Hamvention. HamCation chairman for life.
Nearly.
Peter Meijers, AI4KM. There we go. So it's almost over. How did it go?
The weather was picture perfect.
Yeah, I was talking to one of your guys outside. He said he ordered it that way.
Oh.
The bill's going to come due. I'm not sure how you pay that.
He must have great relations with higher power.
Yeah.
I can tell you that visitors are happy, volunteers are happy, but most foremost and all, the vendors are happy. They have a great sales over here, and they want all to come back next year.
Yeah, how soon do you come up with an attendance estimate or figure?
Yeah, we have to count here and there, see what it is.
Count the tickets, one,
yeah,
two.
Yeah, and we have to make a calculation on people. Some people come through the full 3 days, some come 2 days, so that's what we have to calculate.
Yeah.
And at least I can tell you that we are above last year. And last year was 17,000.
Oh, wow.
And this must be 17,000 plus.
Yeah, I didn't know, because I missed last year because I was sick. I hated missing it. It was the ARRL National
Convention.
Which was huge.
Yeah.
And it brought you up to starting at 9 o'clock on Friday. You'd been a noon opener on Friday.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you started at 9 o'clock, and this year you stayed with the 9 o'clock. Evidently it worked.
Yes.
And it seemed to work this year, too. Without the convention to drive that early opening.
That's what it is.
There were still plenty of people in the arena at 9 o'clock on Friday. So
absolutely,
that's going to be a permanent thing, I guess.
Yes, and to the observation of many vendors, the Friday becomes more and more important as the first day, and given the number of visitors, so overall, it is maybe equal Friday and Saturday, but Friday's importance is growing.
Any changes besides that early opening, or are things pretty much stable with the way the HamFest is run?
Yeah, we did also this year testing on Friday, very successful. 28 people take their exams and 26 pass, so that's great. And we have also on Friday already a number of forums in our forum section in the Lakeside Pavilion.
Yeah, and some on Sunday too.
And Saturday.
Yeah. Well, Saturday is always the big day.
That's the big day, but we try to extend the service to the ham community,
yeah,
so they can come to Friday also for forums if needed. By the way, we have got this year 35 forums.
Yeah, forums, even at Dayton, although they get a lot of people, it's still a pretty small percentage of the folks that come. But they seem important to some people. So you guys treat them as if it's something really...
I give you one sample about the importance. We have also a great presentation from Bob Heil, a big name in the amateur world.
Mm-hmm.
The capacity of the tents were 60. I think nearly 60 were outside.
Yeah, that may be the limitation here, because Dayton's rooms can hold 100 to 200, and a couple of rooms will do 400. And so the tents that you guys put up, if you could count on weather like this weekend, you wouldn't need the tent.
No, but you know, you never know in advance.
Yeah.
Three, four years ago, we got two rainy days, Friday and Saturday, and finally on Sunday it was okay.
Yeah. And then, so the Dayton folks, of course, are moving to a fairgrounds.
Yes.
It's fairly similar to here. I mean, the layout is different, but have they come to learn a lot about doing something at a fairgrounds?
I think so. Number one, we have a very good relationships with the guys from Dara and Hamvention, and it is nice for them to be here. I think they made a more critical view on our operation, how we do it, how we did it.
Did they talk to you a lot about it, or just walking around?
No,
corporate espionage.
Well, we work all for the ham community, number one, so
yeah,
we have nothing to hide, and we can give them information where they want it. They made their own observations, and well, I think this year they don't call it espionage, But this year...
I just did the clickbait thing.
Yeah. This year, they were more focused on their operation, see how we do things, how we do the tailgate, how we do the RV, and that's what they're looking at.
Well, they got a little time, but they're getting to the point where their cake has got to be pretty well baked.
Yeah, that's... Well, they have one big point. People don't like changes.
Yeah.
They have to, due to the closing of HIRA. So now they have to convince everybody, volunteers, vendors, visitors, okay, we are on the other side now, but please come to us and see what we are doing. And that's the important part of the story.
Has this HamFest changed locations since it started?
Well, it started in 1946.
I guess it has.
Yeah. They have. They went to convention center. They went to some hotel chains. So over the years, but here in at the fairgrounds, I believe we are here the last 20 years.
Okay. I'm familiar with a few HamFests that had been pretty big HamFests in the Southeast region. I'm thinking particularly Charlotte and Shelby that had to change location. And also Virginia Beach that changed locations, and they all took big hits. There were other things that were happening. This was in the vicinity of around 2000. Internet was growing, economy went bad. You couldn't tie it specifically to the location change, although Charlotte's was only a few years ago, and they took a hit in making the location change. I know the Dayton folks are worried about that. They're putting on the best face on it, and we're all better off for a big, vital, growing, thriving HamFest community, Dayton and Orlando and others around the country. It would be great if they all come back and thrive again. But the general tone is, well, let's see. Let's see what hams will do.
Well, the silver lining is that the ham community is growing. We see that we have on year base 30,000 extra new hams. And of course, they don't all use or buy radios, but a majority of these new hams are on the air. And that is part of the success, I assume, from the bigger shows, that people come over. And I think one of the big advantages of the shows, of like HamCation and HamVention and all the other shows, you have the feel and touch aspect. If you order a radio or a part over the internet, you don't have the feel and touch. And that's what makes these shows important and likely for the people. Okay, you can turn the knob of your radio, of your wish, you can see how it sounds, how it feels, and that is important.
Yeah. I guess the most worrisome thing that I keep hearing, and it's still very at the level of a very limited anecdote, but I've heard it often enough from enough different people, is, well, I think I'm going to go look this year, but I'm not going to set up anything because I'll see how things go. And if it looks like it's doing good, then I'll come next year and set up as a flea market vendor, maybe even a commercial vendor. Well, if enough people have that attitude, when they get there, they're not going to like what they see. If everyone who says that shows up, sets up, sells their stuff, they will like what they see. So they're kind of going down a self-defeating spiral. So don't do that.
Yeah. Well, some let's say it this way. For years, we had a great show in Miami. 1 week ahead of Orlando.
Yeah, that's another one that took a hit.
Yeah, and it was sad, but due to the passing away of the lady who run the show for a number of years, and there was a discontinuation for a couple of years, and that is very bad for a show. Then you have to build up again your vendors database. People has to know, okay, the show is there. So we have an easy situation. Our founding fathers from HamCation, when they did it in 1946, it continues on until now. This is the 71st year. So we built on the hard work of the guys in those days. And if you want to build up a new show, that's very hard.
Yeah. So anything in the works for next year that would make a change? Or are you just kind of looking at why tinker with success?
We are friendly to our vendors, to our visitors, to our volunteers. That is the trademark from HamCation. And that's what I'd like to see. And I can tell you that already a number of commercial vendors, they came into our commercial chairman, Bob Cumming, W2BZY, and getting their applications for next year already. So there is definitely a great trust.
I guess I better do that.
Great trust in this organization.
Yeah, I'll be back next year. I've mentioned on another show, but I'll mention it again here. You've been great to me because I wasn't able to come last year. I had a booth reserved, but I wasn't able to use it. And I came this year, and you offered, and I hadn't set up for one because it was a bit of a last-minute decision for me. And you said, I've got some space. Would you like it?
That's
and
true.
You put me right here, and this is great.
Well, you do a lot of very good work for the ham community, and that's my, let's say, that's my desire, that we like to serve this community. And if you see the people, their reactions, not only from the vendors, they are very happy, I learned, but also some visitors came to me, great show, thank you. And that's what we like to hear.
Yeah, I see a lot of smiles out there. And it may have something to do with, I think I'm the only ham media that paid attention to you in the first couple of years.
Yeah, well, you are, number one, more than welcome. We appreciate the fact that you take care of us in the media. And we are more and more dependent. That's an important change to the modern media. If you see that we sent out 51,000 flyers with a very expensive mailing. Yeah. And now you see the development of the social media. You see YouTube, you see Twitter, you see Facebook. And that are more and more the important ways to deliver information to the ham radio community.
I'm hearing that. I'm too old. We're both too old. I'm still using it. You know, I only tweet when I got a new show, but I don't use it for gathering information like people do. But I don't disparage that. And I'm on Facebook and stuff. So. Yeah, we're trying to keep up. Damn kids, get off the lawn. All right, thank you, Peter. I'll see you next year.
Thank you, Gary, for having me. And good luck with your show. And we will work from Monday on to HamCation 2018.
Yeah, and you are, by the way, we should mention, a professional broadcaster.
I'm a big part of my professional life, yes. I started my career in newspaper, radio, television, short period of time, PR, back to television station, and I ended my career as a television news director.
So you can tell me whether I'm doing things right or wrong here.
You're doing a terrific job. I have nothing to complain.
Fished for that
And you are a real professional.
All right. Thank you. It is a quickie, pretty much. 73, everybody. KN4AQ. Tell them who you are again.
My name is Peter Meijers. I am Alpha India for Kilo Mike.
And the chairman of the Orlando HamCation.
2017.
For life.
Yeah.
Over and out.
I'm impressed by your technical outfit.